In this video, we're going to be exploring some interesting programming options for Mastercam users who may not have access to a Mill 3D license. For this example, I will be programming some components for the water wheel exhibit for the American Precision Museum in Vermont, here in the United States. This display was designed and machined in our Mastercam manufacturing lab. As an applications engineer with Mastercam, I have all the Mastercam tools at my disposal, from 2D toolpaths right through our multi-axis package. Most mill customers have no need for all those tools. However, occasionally a job will come along that pushes the limits of your current Mastercam capability. If this sounds like you, pay attention. Let's specifically look at the driven gear on this assembly. Shutting off level 2 will isolate the component. First, I'll move the part to the origin. Upon selecting the gear solid, the contextual tab on the ribbon will appear, placing Transform Dynamic right at my fingertips. With Transform active, I want to point out a new feature for Mastercam 2022. By clicking an axis label, I can snap the graphics view to that plane. Place the component at the origin. Click OK to close Transform. From here, I'll select File, Save Some, and save this gear to a location so that I can open it up later. There are a lot of shops, both small and large, that share a limited number of Mastercam licenses across multiple programmers. Not every seat of Mastercam will have the same level of functionality. On this part, there are multiple 3D surfaces, and it sure would be nice to rough the whole part out with a few clicks using the OptiRough toolpath. If I have the luxury of having access to Mill 3D functionality, it would be typical to machine the surfaces with a 3D HST spiral or radial toolpath. I think it's logical to make the assumption that a part like this requires a Mill 3D license. But does it really? I'd argue that it doesn't. Instead, let's look at some standard Mastercam mill functionality. I'll exit Mastercam and start by creating a shortcut that will not consume a 3D license using the new Mastercam 2022 launcher. Go to the Windows search bar on your taskbar and type launcher. If you're anything like me, you likely have multiple versions of Mastercam installed. Make sure you are indeed choosing the new Mastercam 2022 launcher. The Mastercam launcher is an effective way to manage your licenses and product use. I'm going to create a shortcut on my desktop for only using Mastercam Mill and make sure that I'm not consuming any of these other licenses, specifically Mill 3D. Of course, depending on the level of product that you currently own, your launcher options may be slightly different than what you see here. I'll save this directly on my desktop for easiest access and name it Mastercam Mill Only. Navigating to my desktop, I'll double-click and launch the newly created shortcut. Right away, there is a message about product level, confirming that I am indeed only using a Mastercam Mill license. From here, I'll reopen the gear file I saved earlier. Using the default mill machine for this operation, set up stock using the rectangular option, selecting all solids. Add an extra 5 millimeters of thickness to the stock to grip with the fixture. I'll turn the display on as well to visually confirm that the stock setup matches my intentions. Now it's time to rough the part. As discussed, it would be great to be able to utilize the efficiency and ease of OptiRough for a part like this. Well, the team at Mastercam agrees. Brand new for Mastercam 2022, OptiRough is now part of all Mill product levels. If you are a Mastercam Mill customer, this should excite you. This is the single biggest functionality upgrade to the Mill product since the release of our dynamic technology. Let's dive in. Launch the OptiRough toolpath. We start off on the model geometry page, where I'll triple click to select the entire model. Leave 1 millimeter on the floors and walls. On the tool page, create the 12 millimeter bull nose end mill, and then select a reasonable 40 taper holder. Finally, navigate to the cut parameters and use a step over of 25%, a step down of 100%, and a step up of 20%. Click OK and generate the toolpath. With OptiRough being added to mill, I'm now able to completely rough out this part using dynamic motion in a matter of a couple clicks. No chains or specific depth settings required. OptiRough's dynamic technology will increase tool life while decreasing cycle time, just like any of the other 2D HST dynamic toolpaths. The biggest difference here is the reduction in programming effort and time, as well as the ability to match the 3D contour of a part with step-ups. With the part rough to near net shape, it is now time to run some finishing operations. Let's look at surface finishing with some 2D alternatives. Since we are still in a mill product environment, 3D paths like waterline, spiral, or raster aren't available for multi-surface operations. Instead, let's explore using a surfacing toolpath from the 2D gallery. These are all wireframe-based surfacing toolpaths, and as such, we'll need some geometry drawn to be effective. Navigating to the wireframe tab, I will draw a line across the part from the origin out to 3 o'clock, and then project that onto the surfaces. Next, I will create a curve on the outside edge of those surfaces using Curve One Edge. Launch the 2D swept toolpath from the 2D gallery on the ribbon. First, select a partial chain that makes the cross-section of the surfaces from outside to inside. This chain will drive the stepovers in that selected order. Next, grab that outer edge. Press Enter and the toolpath asks for the intersection point. Filtering the auto cursor to select only endpoints, choose the outermost endpoint of the projected curve. Once the intersection is selected, Mastercam launches the toolpath. Create a 10mm ball end mill for this. On the parameters page, specify a step over of 1mm and a stock to leave value of 0. With the toolpath display turned on, I'm left with a clean, efficient toolpath that finish machines the 3D center section. Select both toolpaths and launch Mastercam Verify. Turn on Color Loop to allow for quick identification of the separate operations. Run through the simulation. At this point, I'm ready to continue programming some simple finishing contours, and then flip and face off the remaining stock. What I really want to point out is that this seemingly mill 3D part is not only achievable in the mill level of Mastercam, but actually very simple to program with only a mill level product license. With the 2022 release, the addition of OptiRough makes Mastercam Mill more powerful and capable than ever before. In another video, I'll take this one step further and show how some new tools in Mastercam 2022 can help you leverage even more 3D functionality in standard Mastercam Mill and eliminate the need for using wireframe-driven surfacing toolpaths entirely.